The word bravery to me, it means to be like brave, as to do something. If you want to dance, anything you want to do, you just need to listen to your heart and be brave.
I think another way of being brave is finding joy in the small things in life. I think sometimes we focus too much on financial success or climbing the corporate ladder or big successes or the big things in life. But I think it's sometimes brave to just sit still and make yourself a cup of coffee or a cup of tea and find joy in that small little thing that sometimes you overlook. And I see South Africans being brave on a daily basis, but being brave doesn't need to be big. It doesn't need to be a big show of bravery. It really is the small things.
Bravery means overcoming the obstacles that's in your way, and not to give in to the fear and to allow the fear to hamper your efforts to overcome the danger. Bravery is overcoming danger despite whatever fear may be there.
What motivated me to take part in the Be Brave Mzansi movement is when I found out that I can do it with a charity of my choice, or the charity that I support, called the Surfer Kids. And I love the work that they do, and I love what surfing brings for the kids. It brings joy. And I thought, what better way to share that with the rest of South Africa by doing the dance with them. The dance brings me joy, and I'm sure it's going to bring them joy too, as the surfing does. So I just thought it's a beautiful moment to come together and for a few minutes, 2 minutes, be carefree and find a moment of fun, bubbles of pockets of joy. But whenever I dance, it just puts a huge smile on my face, and that's what the Dance of Brave did for me too. It brings joy, it makes me feel carefree, and it just makes me smile, and it brings me into the present moment. And it makes you feel like you're flying, but you're flying while standing on the ground.
South Africans, I just want to say to you, things are difficult during this pandemic, but I just want to encourage you guys that please rise up together and things will be back in normal.
What lies ahead of you is not what defines you. What lies behind you is what defines you. We react to things that lie ahead of us, but ultimately our behavior and our response is shaped by where we came from. And there have been many crises in the past that we have overcome, you know, and this too shall pass.